idea here is to have three systems connect with each other and communicate, right? So three systems communicate to give some valid data that will be useful for the user, that will be meaningful for the user, right? So one such component is this one. So this one is it's a TI product. It has accelerometer, magnetometer, barometer, temperature sensor, altitude sensor, all kinds of sensor-related data, right? So what we are trying to do is gather the data from here. Accelerometer, gyroscope, and magnetometer, they are basic stuff. But temperature sensor is something that none of the analytics actually have. Right. So since none of it have, we intend to utilize this sensor such that the application can gather this data and update the information to the corresponding user, whoever is nominated. Right. So this will communicate to Android via Bluetooth Low Energy 4.0, the latest one. So we've got this Nexus 7 device. It is rooted to allow Bluetooth 4.0. Right. This has a Bluetooth 4.0 module, but it's not enabled by default. We need to root it and then enable it such that it can communicate through the low energy APIs. Right. So
this one for hacking night.
Right. This one is there. The other one is this setup. So what we have here is an Arduino board connected with an Ethernet communicator, along with it's an 8-bit LCD display, right? So what this display is going to give me is, it is going to read the data, the mobile is going to read the data from this device, it is going to parse this data, identify what are the values, and let's say the user is setting up a particular location, say this building as my home location, right, as my center location. And from this, he can set a threshold wherein if he crosses beyond this location, it will automatically start. This Android device will consistently keep listening for this location, and the moment it detects it is outside of that boundary, it will start listening, getting information. Connect to this, and it will start getting information from this device. And once it gathers all this data, collects it, do some manipulation such that all things are readable for the user, and all those data are uploaded to a server, right? Because we cannot communicate back directly to this setup, right? So it uploads all the details to a server per user. So every single user will have his own account for the server that is automatically created. A database is maintained on the server, right? So we get this information, we upload it, keep it on the server, right? Now this setup cannot have any data pushed to it. So what will happen is with this setup, we'll be constantly pulling the server. And it's again another service call. We'll pull the server and with the device ID. This one is going to have a device ID. Ideally, what would happen is this device will have, this device ID will be mapped to the particular user's account through a CMS or some system, which we are not going to do today, right? But we'll be hard coding this device ID with that. So by mapping the device ID to the particular user, when polling, that corresponding all the details are brought to this device. It gets all the device and shows up. Right? So this application, what it can be intended, the use cases will be people who like to travel much, people who do trekking much, or in certain cases where children, if parents want to know their children's location where they are regularly.
For safety purpose and
safety purposes.
We have special children as well as children who are going far away from home, just
even for old persons. Right? All they need to do is carry thinking of implementations where we can identify a hardware that will use a 3G SIM card and it will automatically communicate with the SIM network, thereby avoiding any purpose where a children needs a phone to do all this stuff. By carrying this device in his bag, it will automatically do all those stuff. But right now what we're doing is through the Android device, it is going to be uploaded. So any travelers, they don't have to constantly call up and say, I'm here. They don't have to remind it. And all sorts of nothing, right? So all these data are going to be already available. Anyone who wishes to know where this guy is, all they need to know is if he is nominated, the data is going to be available in his mobile, already in his device. through this server, right? So, or through this setup, if he has it installed. Let's say in children's case, parent can have the small display somewhere where he can just say, okay, there'll be what is thinking of us, another bigger device that will plot up a map and will pinpoint its location. And it can also show the temperature in which it's currently, any spike in temperature, is it going out of control, right? Sometimes people don't want to be in places where there is it's quite uncomfortable, right? So people will get to know all these information, right? So all this is what the actual idea is. And to extend it further, we also have some sort of a crowdsource idea, meaning people who are trekking or traveling, they can say, okay, I have been in this place, it will constantly keep uploading the data, wherein people who want to trek, they want to know some information, they can always come to a website which will list, okay, some user was at this place, he has recorded, this is the temperature and this is the height at which it is available, etc., etc. So they can be prepared, right? So for the temperature and all those stuff. So that kind of a Twitter kind of update, but with maps involved, with location,
live
involved,
communication,
temperature involved.
Live in extension, we will be also adding the activity recognition API. So like we will also analyze the whole movement of
this whole thing.
So the activity recognition, as you know, it
takes even walking, sitting,
each and every activity. Meaning whether he's cycling or running or driving or walking or he's idle. So that we are planning to do that as well, right? So all this stuff integrated, we are trying to display it somewhere on a portal that can be useful for everyone, not only those who are nominated, right? So that's the whole picture. Whatever we have done right now is we have an Android application that's not yet completely ready, but the logic is there for waiting and listening for GPS and identifying if it is outside of the threshold that is set. So within 10 kilometers, if say I have set this as home location, within 10 kilometers if I am, no problem. If it is outside, it's going to detect the threshold, it's going to automatically indicate, right? So it's going to automatically upload the data. So we have that set up. So Android device right now listens to the GPS and it will get the data. And we are still waiting on, we are integrating Bluetooth Low Energy. We are, and another thing is, he has been working on it. He has been able to start the scan, discover this device, pair with it, and he is able to get the details from this device. It's not parsed yet, we need to parse it, but the data is available.
It's got the data, yeah, I'm trying to parse the data right now.
Yeah.
Because
and we have a specific protocol structure where we get the data in a very raw format, and the conversion techniques are all, it's kind of a raw and I'm getting it from the device. So I need to parse those data, get it in a readable format, and then pass it and then send it to the server.
Bluetooth Low Energy is something that we have actually started here. First thing, we are trying to understand it, we are trying to analyze it, we have not worked on before, so it's taking a bit of
Bluetooth Low Energy is from 4.3 is only available right now in Nexus, not in any other microphones. So we are trying to analyze the most latest API of Android.
And Pratmesh here is actually working on setting up a server, a local server that will actually give me some predefined data. We'll be actually sending the information that we get from this device and the location details from mobile. We'll be uploading it to the server. Services are partially ready. It's not complete yet.
One service
is ready. There are still uploading services ready. Getting the details, that's not yet ready. Right. So getting the details service is required by him. He's the one who's working on this setup, the display setup.
Okay.
Right. So what he'll be doing is he'll be writing a service that will use this device. This service will keep polling the service server, and it will get the information and it will populate that information in a concise, precise manner. What is needed and what is not needed?
Yeah, because we listen to
this display.
We need a bit of
8-bit LCD.
But what we have here is something like a beacon. Beacon does not compromise privacy, but at the same time gives you a small logic of where the person is. So we want to bring that small abstraction. We want to respect their privacy also. But they'll definitely know if they're close or what based on the color codes that the LED will try to give. So if you're near, it will show a hue of
LED light there. Here, which will indicate if the user is outside the boundary, it will start showing up in red color.
Right.
And if he's inside the boundary, it will start showing up in
so
green.
If he's coming near home, it's a green. So people can feel positive that, yeah, he's somewhere near. And if he's very far, or if he's crossed boundaries, that means it will give a red. So we're respecting privacy at the same time giving a general idea of what his position is. So this will be a gradual shift. This is not like red and then green. It shifts from red to green. So it's a hue change of the color so that it shows that he's nearby. But
so
if
you
he's
go
midway,
through that color spectrum.
So we go through the entire color spectrum just to show that he's in progress of coming towards home. So it will not be a jump from red to green. So color codes are also important for us. So it won't be a red and green. We want to show a positive approach wherever it is. So we think of it. But this is a general idea of the hardware that we have there.